Good morning, boys and girls. I keep forgetting it might not be morning for you, it is for me. Welcome to One Go ShortPlay. I'm Mike, your host for the afternoon, evening, night, morning, whatever it is, and lunchtime. And this is Cool Spot for the Sega Mega Drive. This was a beautiful game. Look at that already. I mean, the Amiga version was great because it was a bit more graphically capable, I guess, but that's still, every bit as good, I think. Maybe, to my memory anyway. Look at the lovely animations, look at that water underneath the bottle. Listen to that cool music. That's what I'm talking about. Wasn't Cool Spot 7-Up's character icon? I think he was. He was like the dot on the 7-Up logo, wasn't he? If Cool Collect it, right, you know, that's a nice way to tell you what to do in the game. It just throws a screen at you, you can skip it. If you want to look at it, you can. Ace, off you go. I remember though, this felt to play, if I remember rightly. Yes, I do, and there's a whole area up here. But it's a little bit precarious getting around it. There we go, that way. Because this jump's a little bit floaty. It's actually quite... Oh, am I going to manage this? Yes, it's actually quite a slow game. And I was saying on Contra before, I like the more cerebral. Maybe not quite this cerebral. I do like this though. It is actually a game that is capable of being very accurate despite its floatiness. I think I missed the whole section there. It's a floaty game, especially when you're jumping around, that sort of thing. But it's very cerebral. It's very accurate, the jumping. While you're up there, at least, anyway, this is what I found with it. When you get down here into the action, it's actually really hard not to get hit. As you can probably see. And ultimately, it ain't no Sonic or Mario, you know. It's well designed, it's beautiful, but let's face it, you could design any layout of level to these controls. You just could. You just throw any kind of order of baddies at him. Because the controls are quite nice and accurate, as you can see, they'd have to be to get through a section like this. I'm gonna go down, that's probably a bit of a risk, but yeah. But it's so slow, his movement's so slow, and the collision's not very accurate because, well, look at the shape of him. He's a spot with little flaily arms and legs, so he's... Uh-oh. See, I've landed directly on top of the baddie and taken a hit. There's a lot of that as well, leaps of faith and whatnot, because his jump's really big, and his sprite's big. Not that I'm complaining, I like big sprites. It's just you are likely to get yourself in trouble. Oh, woo! And I feel as I always felt when I play Cool Spot, a little bit like that wasn't very fun. You know, and this is another thing you might notice, his walk, when he does walk, he starts off really slow. I mean, really slow. And he builds up speed over like a really long period of time. And that's, I can see what they were trying to do, that kind of inertia thing, but on a more gradual basis than the likes of Mario or Sonic. Why can't I get you out? I don't need more. I think I need more cool, which is those red spots. Let's see if we can find some more. There's probably loads right back at the beginning, actually. So we'll go back. On riding the balloons, back to the beginning. But he moves so slowly there that he was getting hit by the little shell-type dude. Just because he moves slowly when he gets started. If I stop, and you're always bound to land near or on something dangerous. And baddies move so much faster than you, and you end up in a minefield of them like this. Alright, you can shoot. That's pretty nice, you can shoot in all different directions. It's just something doesn't quite work. Gorgeous animations. And part of me loves the background of this level, you know, the whole seaside thing really works, but part of me also feels that it's quite cheap the way it's done. A lot of repetition, a lot of flat colour, a lot of messy dither in there. To simulate what I guess would be a more realistic level, I'm not sure they've succeeded though. I mean, at a glance they've succeeded, but I think in the long term, I'm not sure. A lot of me, I love that bit of shadow there on the floor. Look at that, such a nice touch. I like what they've done. It's just, I'm not sure it works. Oh, what happened then? I'm trying to be quiet because, you know, neighbours and stuff in the telly in the morning. I'm going to go back and get some cool. Look how slowly I'm moving though. And then look how fast I get. Uncontrollably fast. That sucks. They could have just done a quick inertia over half a second and then to full, I don't know, to half the full speed. Doesn't even need to go as fast as he does once he builds up speed. That's just a stupid design flow. Bad decision, really. No, I don't want to go that way. I want to pick up some cool. I've got 74% of me cool. I just walked into a baddie because I was walking too fast. Too slow. Too fast. Somewhere in the middle and with a sense that I'm actually able to control them. Shame because the jumping is really tight. The jumping, they've got that. I think they've got that very nearly right. He jumps too far, so you have a lot of blind jumps. Oh, bonus level. I want bonus level. I want to finish this level. Yep. Plum. Your big red plum. Alright, let's go and finish this level. At a really slow pace. And now, too fast. See? It's really hard to avoid stuff. Just because that whole inertia thing is just broken. Oh, you. Why you? Why I order? And all the baddies respawned, and we're back there, and it's the same thing we've just done, but over again, with no apparent improvement in our situation. It's alright, Cool Spot, it's beautiful. I did like it. There's so many flaws to it that really scuppered the gameplay. And the main one is just the pace of his movement. How did I get you out? I've totally forgotten. Oh, okay. That apparently did it. I'm not sure what I did there that I did differently before. But there we go. Yeah, it feels really sluggish to move about him. The jumping is great though. Except for the blind jumps. And I think the level design is possibly to blame there. It's just a big open space with a lot of baddies on the ground. And if you're high up and you land in the middle of it, you've had it. Bonus level. Hey, got the bonus level. Alright, I see what we've got to do here. We've got to get red things. So let's just do that as quickly as we can. I am not doing the best job of this. I see, so if we jump on them, bounce all the way up, and then I'm just holding left. That's very 90s music, isn't it? Stop respawning! That's all I wanted, was that one little red thing. That's all I wanted. There we go. I like the little drifts on the 7-Up. But 7-Up, yeah, there you go, see? It is a 7-Up promo. Beautiful graphics. Look at those drips. Sorry, I'm not even trying to collect stuff now. I've just been totally sidetracked by the drips. I think I might have been able to do that if I was focused on it. So I think that's pretty well balanced. I want that one. Yay, got it! Time up, fair enough. I think that was pretty well balanced. That was a nice touch. The extra little hit it took to kill it. Yeah, so it's the 7-Up promo. And it's a really good one. It's certainly better than, what was it, the Pepsi game or something. It's flawed. But it is a good game. It's not one that I feel I need for my collection. I think I enjoyed it more on the Amiga. I'm not sure why. I think maybe the Amiga's just got a little bit more colour to it, a little bit more variety, not variety, but just a little bit more colour, I think is what I'm trying to say. That's that slow start. Oh, that was silly. There was no way of knowing about that really, was there? Maybe the scrolling wasn't catching up with me, I should have spotted it. Up, little finger said up. Yeah, it's good, isn't it? It's just left, right things a bit slow. And I get a bit bored of this one as well, if I'm honest. Oh, really? That's a cool spot. Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.